Well, good afternoon, everybody. And as you can see, I've got my red bandana on. And for anybody that's watched our videos in the past knows, red bandana equals toilet time. So we've got two main issues on the boat that we need to deal with in both toilets. One is the Y valve. So we have a Y valve which either sends the waste up and into the holding tank, or it sends it through another pipe straight out. So those have calcified. The other problem we have is we have some calcification in a couple of the pipes that go off of the Y valve. So we're gonna do our best to try and knock that calcification out of those. I don't have any spare piping. I've looked everywhere, can't find any. We are in the Bahamas, so no surprise. With the Y valve, we're gonna chip away at it very carefully, clean it all out, because right now they're so calcified, we can't actually move the lever to send waste either way. Yeah, so this is always the dirtiest job on the boat. I can't think of anything worse. I've had to work on these toilets quite a few times, but it's gotta be done. Glories of owning a sailboat. So before we do anything, guys, we are gonna send lots of salt water through just to make sure that we are not dealing with waste in the lines at all. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna remove these two bolts to pull off the front of the Y valve. I was going to disconnect all the hoses and take it off the wall and work on it, but I think I can work on it just in here. So we're gonna place a few cloths just over this pump to protect it. I'm gonna put a few more down in here just in case there's any drips. Make sure all of that catches any of the water that comes out of that when I open it. That's it. So I've taken these two off, but the problem is there's one just in behind here. Can't move the Y valve. So I'm gonna have to unscrew the handle here for the Y valve to get access to this one. Screw, so that should just pop off. There we go. And then as you can see, we get access to this screw as well. So you can see the arrows on the Y valve. So we can either send it up, which goes into the holding tank, or we can send it straight out through this one, which heads straight out. So those are the two options. All right, so of course, my plan to, touching my face. My plan to just take the front of this thing off and just clean it out isn't just failed miserably. I'm having to take it off the wall now. I'll unscrew some screws, take it off. I'm gonna have to disconnect some of these pipes. It's just an absolute solid block. So I think the waste out and probably the vertical one that sends it to the tank, I'll have to take off. The one that is obviously from the toilet to the, there's a lot of flexibility in that one, so I think I can leave that one attached. Anyways, let's go.
Okay, so I've taken the bottom screw off of this one, taken the one off here. I've left the other one on the other side. I hopefully should be able to just slide it down now. There we go. So we got a bit more room to work with this. Let's see how we go.
Okay, first pose. Oh God, why is everything so difficult on toilets? All right, so here you can see, I finally got this off. It was such a manic to try and get it off. As you can see, we have a lot of calcification. Those are just where the hoses go on. So you can imagine inside of here how bad it is. So let's open it up and have a look. Okay. There you go, and look at that. That is rock solid. That should be completely empty. Wow, that is much worse than I thought. But yeah, so in here, what you can't see is there's supposed to be this gray, is it gray or black, valve that you turn with the handle that obviously switches the valves. So yeah, so we have to dig all of that grossness out. Oh, well, that's positive. It seems to be more just on the surface here. And it's hollow inside, so maybe not as bad as I initially thought. There you go, these things slide out. So as you can see, still quite a bit in there. So we're gonna spend some time now and just clean it all out.
All right, so I have chipped everything out. Look at that. Imagine what it was like before. So I'm gonna give these a bit of a rinse just in the salt water here at the back. It was a lot of work. I didn't wanna bore you with the details. You can see, look at that. Got all that calcification out. This is the result. All of that was inside our Y valve. So the reason this got so bad is because normally we use just one toilet, but we always try to use the other toilet, like just cycle water through it, because by leaving toilets just sitting, especially saltwater toilets, that is the result. So normally when we use the front toilet, the back toilet we cycle, but when we went away in Canada for a month, when we came back, we noticed the front toilet was starting to calcify and we couldn't use it. So we stopped using it, started using the back one. Of course, we left the front toilet for so long, and it's now, what, beginning of March? It just rock solid calcification. So again, our own fault, but we'll get this front toilet put back together, get it all sorted, and then we'll move on the back one. The back one won't be half as bad because we've been using the back one nonstop. So it should be a faster job.
All right, so here you can see, looking good, all nice and clean, all of these. You remember how bad these were before. So now we're just gonna reassemble it, put it back together. All right, so now we're gonna put this back together. So we have this piece here, which moves around inside, which obviously blocks off certain ways. So that just sits in. Now we're gonna put on our connectors here for the hoses. So those just push right in like that. Here. Okay. And now we're going to put this piece on. Grab our handle to test before we put this back together. So to there. Okay, so there we are. So that is the intake of waste. And then when it's in this position, it sends it directly out. And when it's in that position, it sends it out to the waste tank. So that's essentially the way a Y valve works. So let's reinstall. Okay, so first things first, we're going to screw the unit back together. That's it. And now we'll reconnect the hoses before we bolt it to the wall, just so we have a little bit of movement, because the hoses are gonna be tough to get back on to these. So I had a little look at the hose, and although it's a little bit dirty, there isn't any calcification in these areas. So yeah, I'm pretty happy about that. I don't have to remove all of the hoses and bang the heck out of them to try and get all that calcification out. So that's a one bit of good luck with this so far. I mean, overall, it's gone really smoothly. It's gone exactly the way it has every other time I've done it. So super stoked. Okay, so I've reattached the screws that hold the unit on the wall. Now I'm just gonna tighten the clamps. So a good rule of thumb when you're putting hose clamps on is to always have these opposing each other instead of having them on the same side. So there we go. So as you can see here, we have opposing clamps on either side. Well, that's it guys. This is done. As you can see, Y valve moves perfectly. I can do it with one finger. So that's out direct. That's through the tank. Super simple. Even comes with a little diagram here for the customers, being me and Nat. So that's it. That's the first bathroom done and dusted. I'm not too worried about the other bathroom. I know it's gonna be much faster. I'm not gonna bore you with showing you guys how to do that one. You've seen how I've done the V-Birth bathroom. They're exactly the same. I guess lesson learned, use the toilets. Make sure you're cycling them all the time. Make sure you're cycling the Y valves all the time so that they don't build up calcification. Because if you just leave them, say, on the
either setting, and even though you use them, they can still build up calcification because the valve isn't moving either. So definitely lessons learned for us. You know, you figured 3 years on board the boat, we would have figured stuff out by now, but we're always learning. We're always learning. All right, well, I got a lot of cleaning up to do. Everything stinks, so lots of washing. We're gonna get that done. We're gonna have a shower, and then there's more jobs to do, guys.
Good morning, everyone. Well, as you know, it has been a non-stop computer issues here on Zephyr. Our MacBook Pro was basically bricked due to an update by Apple, and I've had literally like the smartest guy in the world with computers looking at it, and he's basically come to the conclusion that it has to go to Apple because of Apple's trickery with the way they, I don't know, do stuff with their computers. So the difficult thing is that this is our sole computer for making all these videos for you awesome people. And being here in the Bahamas, it's there's no Apple stores, there's nothing, so to buy an Apple computer, first of all, would be ridiculously expensive due to the import taxes they face here, and there's literally not very many people. So I reached out to somebody here in Georgetown in the Anchorage, I put a post out, and unfortunately, we have to buy a computer in the short term. So we didn't want to obviously spend all of our little bit of money that we actually have. But I found an amazing couple. They've got a MacBook Air for sale. They've done such an incredible price for us to help us out. So I'm gonna go by and pick that up now, and then I can get back to making videos. I cannot wait. All right, let's jump in the dinghy and go. All right, guys, well, I made it back. The amazing couple on SV Selkie. Evan, thank you so much, you and your lovely wife, for helping us with this computer. You guys are absolute legends. So what did we get? Well, we didn't think Zephyr was bling bling enough, so we have a MacBook Air in rose gold. so good. So yeah, we're super excited. It's basically brand new. So now I can get back to work. Well, it's another beautiful day here in the Bahamas, and after yesterday's massively, disgustingly dirty job of cleaning the pipes and the Y valve and the toilet, today, job number two is I'm gonna scrub the bottom of the hull. So for those of you who remember, we did a fresh anti-fouling back in late October. So what's it been now? About 5 months, give or take. And so we're gonna check it out, see what it looks like. We have not scrubbed it since. We've sailed a lot, which is always good. Let's see how it looks. So that's pretty good. So I gave the hull a good scrub. I was actually really impressed with how good it's been after just over 5 months. We haven't scrubbed it once since we anti-fouled it. And we were sitting in Bocas, we sat in Linton Bay, Panama, we were sitting in Cartagena. So we were in like, you know, we were sitting around quite a lot while we were waiting for weather to cross here to the Bahamas. There's like a little bit of a little white fur that you can sort of see in patches. The main concern actually is the prop, because the anode finally packed it in and it's fallen off. So I've ordered a new anode, and then once I have that, I'll give the prop another scrub.
But I noticed without that anode, it's just, wow, the prop has just packed up full of sea creatures. Also, guys, I want to remind you, we still have a few spots left in April and a few spots left in May for our Zephyr experience. We've been so happy with the amount of response that we've got. We got some amazing people coming to join us for some time here in the Bahamas. And if you're interested, if this is something that you're really excited, you'd like to give a try, go to sailingzephyr.com. All the information's there. And send us an email if you have any other questions. And of course, thank you so much to all our wonderful patrons and to our new patrons that have signed up this week. We've had 3 new patrons. You guys know who you are. Thank you so much. Honestly, guys, without this Patreon support, we would not be able to continue at all. This journey is only made possible by you, and it only continues because of you guys' support. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts. If Natalie was here, she would also thank you as well. So on that note, great news, Natalie is on her way back to Zephyr after visiting her family in Spain. I'm so excited to see her. This boat is just not the same without her. And I'm sure all of you out there have been missing seeing Natalie on screen as well. I'm sure you're tired of seeing me, only me at this point. So yes, she will be returning in just 7 days. So either in the next video or the video after, she will be back on your screens, making you all laugh. All right, guys, thanks for watching and have a good afternoon.